Dr. Indranil Ghosh from Apollo Gleneagles Hospitals, Kolkata, live with us today, and we'll be discussing lung cancer. Sir, the first and most primary question, what is lung cancer?
Lung cancer is a cancer arising from the lungs. A cancer means any uncontrolled growth of cells in the body. So all organs of our body have got cells which proliferate at their own pace normally, and which is totally controlled. But sometimes because of some illness, this control can be lost, and all the cells are growing at their abnormal pace, which can give rise to a tumor or a mass of cells which are all abnormal, not the normal cells. And this is called the cancer, and from that tumor it can also spread to the lymph organs, lymph glands surrounding that part, other parts of the lung, other parts of the other organs of the chest, and also outside the chest sometimes.
So what exactly is the problem of lung cancer in India?
Lung cancer is the most common cancer in India, especially among males. So we have almost or more than 70,000 new cases every year, and because most of them are diagnosed at an advanced stage, more than 80% of them eventually die of this disease.
We see that this is a disease which comes, as you said, at a more advanced state. So what are the risk factors of lung cancer?
First and foremost is smoking. Smoking either by cigarettes or bidi, both are equally bad. So this is the most common cause of lung cancer. Now sometimes we see that maybe 10% of all lung cancers, they are not caused by smoking, or the patient does not have any history of smoking ever. So what can be the cause in them? One can be second-hand smoke or passive smoke. Somebody else is smoking and that person is just as a bystander is inhaling the toxic substances. Third can be environmental pollution. Especially in cities there is a lot of pollution, and pollution also contains many cancer causing substances. So it is also a cause. A part of environmental pollution is indoor air pollution. Sometimes in rural communities, women cook in open stoves or something like that, with wood and all, wood or coal. These things lead to a lot of smoke and can give rise to cancer as well. Radiation is also one cause. By radiation, I mean ionizing radiation, which is found close to nuclear power plant or atomic disasters, and sometimes also in chemical or some nuclear industries which deal with nuclear fuel, that radiation can cause lung cancer.
What are the most common symptoms of lung cancer?
Most common symptoms are cough. Cough is the most common. Sometimes it is neglected and it's like a normal cough, but it doesn't go away. So any cough which persists beyond 2 weeks needs to be investigated. There can be shortness of breath, maybe not at rest, but if the person moves around or does even the normal activity can give rise to shortness of breath. There can be pain in the chest. There can be bleeding in sputum. So in our country, tuberculosis is a common cause of blood in sputum, but lung cancer is also very common. We need to keep that in mind. Not all blood in sputum is due to tuberculosis, so we need to investigate the patient accordingly before prescribing any anti-tubercular treatment. There can be hoarseness of voice. The normal voice of the person gradually becomes hoarse, and it's person is having difficulty speaking. That can be a manifestation of lung cancer. If the cancer becomes advanced, there can be other symptoms as well, like weight loss, reduced appetite, pain in other parts of the body. If the cancer spreads to anywhere like bones, there can be pain in those areas, so on and so forth. There is a long list.
Like the other cancers, can we say that lung cancer is also a lifestyle disease, majorly?
Yeah, definitely it's a lifestyle disease because its primary driving factor is smoking. So, 9 out of 10 lung cancers in India are because of smoking. So, smoking is a part of lifestyle. So, if we can take out smoking, then we are left with only 10% of lung cancers which we have got today. So, definitely it's a lifestyle disease.
How is lung cancer diagnosed?
Yeah, as the symptoms I mentioned, we need to be well aware of those symptoms. If a person is having such symptoms, especially if it's beyond 2 weeks and not relieved by the normal treatment of any illness, then we need to think about lung cancer and investigate accordingly. Common investigations are, usually we start with a chest X-ray and it shows something. Even if it doesn't show something, or if it does, then we have to go for a CT scan of the chest. It may be accompanied by CT scan of abdomen too for the complete staging. Sometimes PET CT or PET scan is required. It is also a form of imaging, but with more advanced positron emission technology in nuclear medicine. All of these can give some idea regarding what is going on, but the final proof is always by a biopsy. So biopsy means taking out part of tissue from the tumor and studying it under microscope in the pathology lab. It can be commonly done in two ways. One is by bronchoscopy, where a instrument or camera is put inside the windpipe, and under direct visualization the pulmonologist takes a sample, or we can do a CT guided procedure, which is done by inserting a needle through the chest wall under CT scan guidance precisely into the tumor, and the tissue is taken out. So by biopsy we establish that the disease indeed is cancer, and through the CT scan and PET CT scans we can diagnose the stage of the disease as well.
What are the different types of lung cancer?
Broadly, there are two types. The more common one is non-small cell lung carcinoma, and the less common one, which is only about 10 to 15% of all lung cancers, is small cell carcinoma. Now, non-small cell carcinoma has got many, many types. Like most common is squamous cell carcinoma and adenocarcinoma. Adenocarcinoma nowadays is more common. There are a few other types as well. And nowadays the classification has become more complex, because not only the type, we need to look at the genetic features of the tumor. Which genes are altered in the tumor, because those things nowadays decide the treatment. So classification broadly, small cell and non-small cell. Small cell is more aggressive. Non-small cell is less aggressive than small cell, but it's also an aggressive disease by its own right. So that's.
So like any other cancer, even lung cancer is, it creates a fear among the patients. So they would like to know how we can treat lung cancer.
Yeah. Lung cancer treatment depends on its stage. As I said, the CT scan and PET scan, these are important for staging the disease. Now, once we stage the disease, there are broadly four stages. Stages 1, 2, 3 and 4. In 1 and 2, the treatment remains, the gold standard is surgery, which is sometimes followed by adjuvant chemotherapy and sometimes some other treatment like targeted therapy. Stage 3, its surgery can be done in some patients, but most of the time we require radiation along with chemotherapy. in stages 1 and 2 sometimes surgery cannot be done because the patient has got some other illnesses like cardiac diseases or lung function is not good. Those patients cannot undergo surgery. There also we can give radiation or radiotherapy with a good result. Stage 1 and 2 with surgery or radiotherapy result is good. Stage 3, either by surgery followed by chemotherapy or most of the time radiation plus chemotherapy, result is not that good. Most of the patients will not get cured, but the disease can be controlled for a longer period of time. In stage 4, it means that the disease has spread to other organs. So unfortunately, in this stage, the disease is not curable, but it can be controlled by a number of ways. The age-old treatment is chemotherapy, where medicines are given which attack the cancer cells but also attack the normal cells of the body. The side effects are more. We now have targeted therapy, where we can test for various genes on the tumor and find out which gene is activated more and target that gene with a specific drug. This is not applicable for everybody, but many patients it's applicable. And here, because the normal cell killing is very less, the side effects are also much less and the activity of the drug is also much more. Another form which has come up in recent times is immunotherapy. Immunotherapy doesn't attack the tumor cells directly or the cancer cells directly. It only improves or boosts the immune response of our body against cancer. So the body's immune system becomes much more effective in dealing with the cancer and eliminating it. And with much less side effects, we can achieve much better efficacy. And some patients, fortunately, even in stage 4 with immunotherapy, can live many, many years even without disease. So we don't know what will happen to them in future because the modality is relatively new. But we have some patients who were basically free of disease even in stage 4, and they are doing well on immunotherapy. So maybe 5 years or 10 years, how long they will do well, we don't know. Only the future can answer.
So we speak about this different stages or different advanced levels of lung cancer. So can lung cancer be detected early?
Yeah, lung cancer can be detected early. There is a specific subpopulation for whom we can offer that screening. We call this screening, where we do a low-dose CT scanning in patients, those who have a long history of smoking or heavy smoking. These patients are more likely to have lung cancer. So we can screen them yearly with a low-dose CT scan and we can pick up the disease at a much earlier stage. Ideally in stage 1, where it can be treated quite easily.
So before we sign off, the last and the final question that everyone would be asking, listening to the seriousness of the topic, can lung cancer be prevented?
Lung cancer can easily be prevented in the sense that, as I told, out of 10 lung cancers in India, 9 are because of smoking. So if we don't smoke, then that 9 out of 10 is gone. So only 10% will be there, which is not immediately, we don't have anything to prevent them, but we can prevent 90% of lung cancer if we don't smoke. If we start smoking and quit, then also the risk is reduced. But it's much, much better if we don't start smoking at all.
Thank you, Doctor, for sharing your thoughts, your valued information with our audience today. I'm sure we'll have more questions, people who would like to know more, and we'll connect with you as soon as we get them. Hope to connect with you soon. Thank you.
Sure.